Hey, all right, and we're back. Yeah, a little bit of history now. How was your weekend? I hope it was good. Here we go. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah. All right. Time to get started. Here we go. All right. A little bit of Post Malone for us today. Hope everyone's doing well. Whew. This is kind of getting old, isn't it? Oh, my goodness. So I'll tell you what. I'm going to go ahead and get started here. I got a little bit for you today. Hopefully, you're cruising right along with what we're doing. But first, I want to show you here some data. Okay, so this is from our first two lessons that I have posted. And this is the data, the responses, students that have checked in, they've done the work, they've filled out the Google form. I haven't looked at our work yet, but I'm going to soon just to kind of keep my eyes on it. But you can see here for our first lesson, you can see A1 was at 22% of A1, 12 students completed it, 13 students, so 24% of them are 13 students from A4, all right? You can see A3, 14 students, about 26%, and then A2, way to go, they won, all right? So out of the 54 students that completed it, 27% of them were from A2. So that's not over half of the students completed the first assignment. Awesome job. All right, let's continue to reach out to people, make sure that they're getting my updates and my information. So you can see the one that I posted on Wednesday, a lot less. All right, so maybe students are still working on it. You can still work on that assignment, just find it in Google Classroom. But you can see it's a little bit of a different story. Well, not really. A2 is killing it again. 10 students. So let's say A2 is really, really rocking it out. And then, you can see we got a little tight race here with my 7th grade A1 and A4. All right. So that's just a little bit of data to show you that students are working. They're active. Okay. So I wanted to start off by looking at what we were saying. Remember, on the form that you complete after you did docs A through C, you can see here it says which document stood out to you the most and why did it stand out to you. So remember what we looked at. There was a map, and then there was, I believe, two firsthand accounts that we were working with, right? So here's Doc B, Giovanni, and then another one, so we're working a lot with Giovanni's work. I'm kind of breaking it up. So if I go back here, you can see C was a popular one because it talked about the symptoms. The student said Doc B because it said their noses would gush blood, so pretty eye-opening. That's a good point. This person, Doc B, was because it showed more detail of the diseases. Doc A shows the way that it spread. Doc C showed the first time they were really helpless and clueless. That's a very good point. Another Doc C thinks it's interesting that they don't have the kind of technology we have. Doc C stood out to me because it's explaining how the people caught it and took control over the control. Come on down here. The second one stood out to me most because it was realistic and it didn't sugarcoat anything. See, that's what primary sources do. It is what it is. There's no one there interpreting it for you. You're interpreting that primary source. So this person said it was a cold, hard truth, and I like the gruesomeness of history. What's the reality of history is what we're talking about, all right? It is what it is, right? This is what happened, okay? This is what went on. Okay, as I continue to come down here, I look at Doc A. This person, they found out it spread from China, kind of where it began. Oh, look at this response. What I think stood out to me the most was how the doctors saw how many people were dying and were sick and they could not do anything and they would not care how people would not last more than 3 days. That is absolutely crazy. Not everybody's symptoms were the same, and how people in the East, their noses would be gushing blood. People's armpits would be swollen black and purple. Well, to me, that is what stood out to me the most. This person, like Doc C, A lot of information dealing with the black plague. The plague was very serious. There was a lot lack of doctors, so men and women stepped up to help. There wasn't a cure to help the dying patients, and the doctors weren't educated properly, so they didn't know what to do. I could go on. There's a lot of good thinking here. I mean, man, oh man. This one here, I just want to point this out. This, I mean, I like that you like Doc too, but tell me what was the interesting information. Okay, so what was it? Give some detail there, okay? Just give a little bit more detail. But other than that, I would say you guys are doing a really good job. And we had 32 responses. If you're watching this, please do this assignment before you go on to the one I show you today. All right, you can find it in Google Classroom. So these assignments really don't have a time frame. I'm not grading them, but I'm just setting them up for you so we can move forward in our learning. So I'm very proud of you guys. All right, so if we look at our assignment, okay, for today, April 6th through April 8th, okay, so I'll post another one up on Wednesday, so you'll have the next few days to work on this. First of all, I'll remind you of my office hours, 1:30 to 2:30 each day, Monday through Thursday of this week. I won't have them on Friday as we move into spring break. And I won't have any assignments next week either. I don't think any of us are going to have them. Because it's like spring break, and you're like, well, what am I gonna do? I know. Hopefully, you'll be able to kind of go for some car rides, maybe, and some walks, and maybe kind of get creative. But anyways, I just wanted to let you know that. But I did have more students come and see me during my office hours. I saw Abby. I saw Dominic. Man, he was all over it. I saw Hannah Wade. I'm sorry, that was her sister. I saw Maddie Wade. Danny popped on and said hello. Ella popped on. So I want to see more students come on and just chat about what we're seeing with this, or we can just talk about things, okay? So here's the assignment, all right? You have, I'm going to show you, I added more docs, okay, to our BBK. Oh, what's this? Another song by Mr. Underwood? Rainbow on my window pane? Huh. Well, I dropped another song, folks. If you want to listen to it, it's actually pretty good. I was inspired by the artwork my kids did on my window to kind of bring solidarity and hope to this very tough time. So I wrote a song. I kind of like it. It's kind of catchy. So go ahead, click on it, share it. You might be singing that song as well. All right. So there's that. The video you can see, that I'm recording will be posted here. And then I'll go over this, the form that you need to check in with. Now there's nothing here, all right? And the reason is because you already have the recording doc. Okay, it's the recording doc that you received last week. So it's the Black Death BBK. If you're not, if you're This is the first time seeing my video. Go to the assignments. You'll find it. It's the April 6th assignment. Or actually, I'm sorry, it's the April 3rd assignment. You'll see that and you can get working on this doc, okay? So you're continuing to work on this doc. As right now, if you've been working on it, you have part A, doc B, doc C already done, okay? Now you're going to move into the doc D, and I have added them here, okay? Now, I believe I've added four docs, not three, okay? Because I kind of want to be done with this by this week so we can move on and move forward a little bit. All right, so here we have doc D, C. Oh, I got to fix that. Oh, wait, A, B, C. I got to know my alphabet. Duh. Doc D, E, F, and G. All four of these docs are more excerpts from Giovanni Boccaccio. So you're going to be reading his firsthand account. And it's going to be telling you different things. Now, I want you to keep in mind how we're doing this. Keep in mind our guiding questions. What was the Black Death? How did people respond in the time? What false beliefs did people? What false beliefs did people in that time have about the disease, and how has modern science taught us more about the Black Death? Okay, so these are our guiding questions. Remember, you're going to identify five things that stand out to you. Then you're going to ask yourself the question, what question does this doc support? It is okay to highlight more than one. It's okay to highlight the same one. But you're going to be working with these guiding questions, okay? And you're going to be writing your responses down here. How does this address the guiding question? Okay? And so you're going to do all four of those, all right? And then you're going to go back to your assignment here, and you're going to click on the feedback form, okay? So you can see your same setup, same question, but I added a question here. But let's go back to this question. Which document stood out to you the most, and why did it stand out to you? So remember, give detail. What out of all four, which one do you think is the most impactful to your understanding? And then, if you want me to come in with a different song, I got four choices here for our karaoke or groove time as we as I set up my next lesson. Do you want me to come in with "Old Town Road," "Don't Stop Believin'," "Country Roads," or "Sweet Child of Mine"? So go ahead and vote for one, and I will look at the data, and then I will come in with that song. All right, I want to remind you of my office hours. Do not forget, if you have any questions, come on over. Let's talk. Let's kind of, chat a little bit. And I hope you're doing all right. I hope you're hanging in there. I hope that you are just really doing your part. This will be over, guys, and just stay healthy and stay close to your family because they're really important, okay? All right, so Mr. Underwood is out. Let's see, let's have Post Malone take us out, all right?
Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck.
There we go.
Crash at my place,
Oh,
baby, I'm a
yeah.
wreck. Thinking in a bad way, losing your grip. Screaming at my face, baby, don't trip. Someone took a big L, don't know how that felt. Looking at you sideways, party on
There we
tilt.
go. Ooh, see you
Ooh, something
guys.
to